In my previous video, I showed you in-depth review of the Apple AMD Radeon Pro W6800X Duo GPU. In fact, on paper, the most powerful GPU for Apple ever made. But not everything was all rainbows and unicorns. The W6800X Duo had huge overheating problem, and the performance was also not any mind-blowing. It had also no branding printing on it, so I returned it back to Apple and asked for a replacement unit. And here it is. This is the new one. So I put it through its paces again. So is the performance better now with the new unit? Does this card still overheat? Let's have a look. Hi, I'm Teresa from morgonau.cloud and I provide personal individual support with Apple Mac, Windows, Linux and servers. So if you would need any help, just join my website membership. Link is in this video description. And I will help you during a video call and remote session directly to your computer in front of your eyes. Watch really this whole video because I will reveal also one not known interesting bonus information. So I removed my Radeon Pro Vega 2 cards out and installed the W6800X Duo as the only GPU to my 2019 Mac Pro to avoid any interference or false readouts. Booted my Mac Pro and immediately checked the temperatures. The problematic GPU proximity 6 sensor was showing 70 degrees of Celsius instead of 100 last time. So far so good, right? So, was the first unit really defective? Watch further, it's gonna be more interesting and not so easy. So, I jumped straight to the Luxmark test in which I boiled the W6800X Duo in my last video. So, within just 2 minutes, the GPU reached 100 degrees of Celsius on the GPU proximity 6 sensor, but gave expected score over 100,000 points. Let's repeat the test to see if this card will throttle down due to this high temperature. Within just next 40 seconds, the W6800X Duo reached again temperatures over 110 degrees of Celsius and went outside of measurable range of the TG Pro application. Before end of the second run, all cores reached over 90°C, hottest core 96 degrees of Celsius. Yeah, as expected, second score is significantly lower. So, let's do third run. And in just another 40 seconds, most of GPU cores are in the 90s again, hottest core 98 degrees of Celsius. But this time already the bottom fan reached almost maximum RPM, so the whole Mac Pro was extremely loud. So I ended up this test because it's clear now this card overheats and is throttling down. It's like you would put massive engine to your tiny car and you could not use its power because the engine will overheat. Crap! So I ran also other tests as in my last in-depth video review to see if there is some difference. Just briefly. The Basemark GPU score was little bit lower than the last time. Let's quickly jump to the DaVinci Resolve candle test. Previous Radeon Pro W6800X Duo card, which I thought is faulty, achieved 45 FPS in 66 blur nodes, new replacement unit only 40 to 42. In 60 RN nodes, previous one achieved 37 FPS, new replacement unit only 34 to 35 FPS. That's even lower than the so-called defective GPU. I tested it also on my past video project, where this new W6800X Duo had the exact same render time as the previous one. Exactly same was also the render speed in Blender, 1 minute 34 seconds. But surprisingly higher was score in Blackmagic Raw Speed Test, where the new card achieved 335 FPS over 311 on the last GPU. In all other tests, the new replacement unit behaved exactly the same as the previous card. But then I had an idea. What will happen if I will put this W6800X Duo to my 2019 Mac Pro as a second GPU to the third slot and let my Vega Pro 2 card in the first slot just to drive my displays? Ha! This is interesting. All sensors in the TG Pro now completely changed. It's reading out now only the Vega Pro 2 card and no readings from the W6800X Duo, because the proximity 6 sensors is showing now absolutely fine numbers. Okay, so let's retest the Luxmark again. Yeah, unfortunately no surprise here. as indicated this time by the middle Mac Pro fan, which is running almost at maximum again, the W6800X Duo is still overheating. Oof. Okay, but at least I tried. So, if some users claim their Duo card is not overheating just because they see no high temperatures in the TG Pro app, are also wrong. The TG Pro is showing simply in dual GPU configuration only sensors related to the GPU installed in the first slot and not in the third slot. So those who, after watching my previous in-depth review of the Radeon Pro W6800X Duo GPU Monster, believed I had a defective unit, was unfortunately wrong. This new replacement unit is massively overheating too, and produce in almost all tests even worse results than the previous unit. So people, please, don't be fooled by Apple and hype around these new 6000 series Navy RDNA 2 GPUs. It's nothing special. As I showed in my previous video, no matter it has better 3D rendering than the Vega Pro 2 card, when in 3D viewport performance it's even absolute trash, or in video editing is on par or even slower than two Vega Pro 2 cards. Apple, seriously? $5,000 or even 5,750 euros if in Europe for this overheating innovation? No, sorry, you will not keep my money. I already began the process of returning it again. So, I hope I saved you a lot of money now and made your day again a little better. If so, please click on the like button and share button below so it can help to more people, and that will in return help to this channel and help me to produce for you more interesting video like this in future. So, thank you for watching, take care, and see you by my new video or live stream. Bye bye, my Macintosh friends.